Just outside Henley is architectural and antiques expert Gary Wallace, who stores all his items in a giant converted shed.
I've been in the business for 30 years. I specialise in specialising nothing, basically. If I like the look of it, I buy it, and it covers a very broad section of items. Having done the fair circuit for many years, obviously, Drew and I have crossed paths on a number of occasions, so I'm sure he will find something of interest, and I hope we can strike a deal.
Good to see you.
How you doing?
All right, how are you? Good, mate. Wicked. Well, I've not been here before. Looks great. I've seen you at the, you know, the fairs, but I didn't know you did all this.
Yeah, no, it's a bit more to it than most people appreciate, really.
Cool. And the motorbikes everywhere.
Oh, yeah, we got the odd bike.
How many have you got? I can see one, two, three, four, five, six, seven from here.
There's a few more not tucked around.
Oh, my God.
And a few in pieces as well.
God. I like it. It's cool. It's very cool, isn't it?
It is. It's amazing.
It looks great. It looks great.
First impressions are good. Any antique shop that has got motorbikes hanging from the ceiling is somewhere I want to be. You know, he's a good trade dealer, so we're hoping that there'll be stuff I can pick up. And he's gutsy, you know, he buys big stuff, which I like.
And what's the fascination with these things? There's loads of these lying around as well.
There's a few. They're just a love of mine. I've been going to France for years and years, buying and selling and that sort of thing, and if I see one, I buy it. Yeah, no, I love them. They're just a really good...
Do these have a dive setting? So when... and another player goes near, they just fall down.
Oh, he's fallen over.
clutching the leg.
With plenty of eye-catching items available, Drew needs to find something to bid on to make the long trip worthwhile.
I like the look of this, Gary. That's a funky-looking thing. It's all right,
yeah.
Needs a bit of work.
Unfortunately, we broke the top in transit, but bought it from France, a museum cabinet, I think.
Yeah, it's all right, isn't it?
Yeah.
You must use the same shippers as me. They smash everything
up
as well.
Exactly, yeah.
So do these attach or they're just set on the floor like that? And no wonder it broke. I've got a lot of these, but, you know, I always like this sort of gear.
What I like about the museum cabinet is it's not too big. It's raw steel. That always looks pretty cool and edgy. But the best thing about it is the old painted decoration to the base is really good. It's sort of faux marbling into almost camouflage. It's great, and it's largely unrestored and untouched, which is something as I always want.
This display case from the turn of the 20th century has a square, tapered base. With the original lock still in place, this piece would be ideal for jewellery and watch retailers. Once the glass is fitted, it could be worth around £1,200.
What money's that as is?
£450.
£400?
Yeah, let's get the ball rolling.
Yeah. Thank you. Deal. Marvellous.
Paid £400 for it, that's fine. Dealing with dealers is just an awful lot easier. You generally get the best price straight away. And you know what you're getting.
Very happy with that. Very happy with that.
What happened?
It's yours now, it doesn't matter.
Drew's had success downstairs, but with two floors to sort through, he's determined to find more deals.
Oh, cool, look at this. Excellent. Yeah, you'd never know you're in a shed now, would you?
No.
it looks really good. This looks great. Oh, yeah, tell you what, that's a belter, isn't it?
Absolutely, yeah.
Lovely. It's keen on the frame, but...
Well, it's the original frame, but you could probably get back to the original paint on that, I think.
Yeah.
It's an exceptional mirror.
Yeah. He's building it up now. The next thing we chat about, and you really can't miss it, is a superb, distressed, large plate glass mirror on the back wall. It's this type of mirror I adore, and that is one of the better ones I've seen. It's an absolute belter. They appeal to nearly every dealer I know. I can't stand new, modern mirror. It's too sharp, it's too aggressive, and it has no feeling to it. Where that just looks like a map of the world, doesn't it?
This mid-19th century mirror is probably French and would have been used in a shop or restaurant. Antique mirrors can become heavily distressed as the back gets tarnished and oxidised. This can often be worse around the bottom, where moisture from cleaning settles. A mirror with aging like this demonstrates that it's a true antique. And once the frame is touched up, it could be worth around £2,500.
Go on then, give us a price.
£1,200.
I had a figure in my head when I looked at it, it was a grand.
You don't want to meet me in the middle?
Not really.
1050. 1100. 1100, 1050, 1075. All right, yeah.
There you go.
Fair enough.
Yeah. Restoration on this is very simple. We'll secure the frame, we'll make sure the frame's perfect. Then we're going to scrape that layer of paint off, try and get down to the original painted surface that's underneath that nasty black paint that's on it now. T, you've got to be really, really careful with that.
So you're not going to help me with it? Then?
No.
Drew's spent £1,475 on two items, but something else has caught his eye.
Also like this, what's all this about here?
Conversation seat. I like the scale of it, it's just bigger than normal. I think that's the original fabric.
It is.
The upholstery seems to be in reasonable condition.
A strange conversation seat, so if we're having a conversation, yeah. I'll sit here with my back to you.
Well, I've always wondered that about these things, but it's obviously for married couples.
Yes. Perfect, I'll take it. It's got so many things going for it. Number one, it's unrestored. Number two, it's complete. Number three, it's got original fabric on it that's just... It's just dead right for now, that one.
This late 19th century conversation seat has original silk fabric and cabriole legs, made in a subtle S shape. Conversation seats became fashionable from the late 18th century to accommodate large, delicate dresses and gentlemen's coats. This one was probably custom-made for a manor house or hotel, and when touched up, could be worth around £1,500.
I'd be honest with you, I'd like to get 900 quid for it.
Strangely, I've got a thing about numbers because I'm very dyslexic and I don't like 7, 5 or 9.
Really?
No. I like so sixes and eights.
What about 10?
Not keen.
Even less keen.
Even less keen. Just because I don't like the number 9. 880? It's odd. I know it's odd, but I just don't like the number 9. It's horrible.
I can't argue with that. That's fine.
Yeah.
You could never say no, even in German.
The good news is we've got minimal work on this. All we will do is brush the timber work down. We won't re-French polish it or do anything else to it. I want it to look as raw as possible. I don't want that altering in any way, really.
Three deals done on three large pieces, and room in the van is running out. But Drew's not finished yet.
Little jeweller's thing, yeah?
Yeah, I think so. It's jewellers or watchmakers, I wasn't really sure.
Would have been used by a watchmaker or somebody working on close engraving work or drawing. And the shape and the colours that it is and the textures, it's just great. And it's also beautifully designed.
This mid-20th century magnifying glass is made by British optical manufacturers Newbold and Bulford Company, nicknamed NBCO. Although no longer trading, their products are still known for their quality. For a specialist dealer or private enthusiast, it could be worth around £400.
How much is that then?
I'd like to get £240 for that.
Mm, okay. Yeah, I have to have it, even if I just get my money back. I love it.
All right.
Yeah.
Cool. No, I'll put
two. That's great. That. Love that. Beautiful. Sorry, so you can look for your wages through that, can't you?
it's not that strong.
Superb. Very happy with everything I've got. Done really well. Better than normal, haven't we, T?
Yes, very good.
That's great fun. Very enjoyable. I mean, dealing with Drew's very straightforward, dealer to dealer. He picked out things that he liked them for the similar reasons to me. So design and desirability. Good day. Good day's work.
Today was excellent. I came to a place I haven't been to before. All of the things I bought today all have one thing in common. It's that patina, it's that untouchedness, it's that being allowed to be worn out and still look better for it.
All done?
Yep.
Sorted. Gary, pleasure.
Cheers, Drew. All the best.
See you at the deck fair.
Thank you for
today. Definitely, yeah, cheers.
All right, mate.
Cheers.
Thanks.
To you. See you later. Bye bye. See you, mate.
There you go, we did well.
You did?